All right, y'all, for this week, we're going to be trying to get the motor to start right. So, I don't know what went wrong last week. It could be simple stuff. It could be a battery. It could be the spark plugs. Could be the one of the carburetors. I believe it's one of the carburetors because I'm getting a lot of gas is coming out behind the little air vent deal. So they probably one of them floats is sticking out, but I don't know which one it is. So instead of trying to nitpick and figure out which one is which, I'm gonna just break them all down, change them out. I went and got the carb kits this morning. Spark plugs. I went and bought the spark plugs this morning. I already put them in. The only thing I'm kind of that it might be, it's probably the battery. If I told y'all how my boat was set up, y'all'd be like, you know, probably should start with there. But I am a college student, so even with the carburetors, I'm about to kind of, I mean, I'm gonna do them right, but I'm gonna, you know, some of y'all might not like the way that I do them, but it's gonna work out. It's not my first time doing this, so you know, we'll see. I'll show y'all, you know, the steps. I got some more stuff that I'm gonna be adding and fixing up to the boat. I'll make some videos on that as we progress. And I do believe tomorrow I'm gonna try to get out there and see if how we're running, see if we can get, you know, how we're going. So yeah, I might get some fishing content in this video too. Other than that, I'll get y'all into the video.
Wait a minute. Oh, God damn it, again.
All right, y'all. So I'm trying to work on my motor. And like I said, it hadn't been getting no gas. The other day when I was running, it was surging and stuff. And this is why you work on your own stuff. So instead of me going to the shop and spending $300-$400 to get them changed out my carburetor, I went through it myself, find out that I got this line that run in between two carburetors. Wasn't even on there. It was on one side, not the other, which is why I'm getting gas all in the bottom of my motor. That's why I got gas leaking all over the place. And it's probably why the bottom carburetor probably wasn't getting any gas to it either. So it was like, you know, whatever little bit of gas he was getting wasn't enough to get it started. So you can look in there and see that's completely ripped. Wasn't even on there, both sides. They come all the way off. Not even on there. So I'm gonna keep looking to see if I see anything else. No, it's probably wrong. Okay. I mean, I understand that this don't supply all of the gas to it, but I'm sure that this don't help. tell us about it. So just a little tip, check your own stuff first, because like I said, I could have sent my boat motor off to mechanic, whatever, charging me $100, anywhere between $100 to $120 an hour. I think they charge about an hour for each carburetor, so you figure 3 hours, that would have been right at between $300 to $400 easy that they would have charged me for that. And it was really just as simple as changing out a line, which I didn't change. I'm gonna change it later. I just don't feel like going to the store right now. But all I did was I just cut the two bad ends off, hooked it up, hooked it back up, let it pull some of the air and stuff out, and it starts every time as soon as you first hit it, it crank right up. So I'm gonna still take it out tomorrow and do a test run. I'm pre-fishing for the for tournament tomorrow anyway. So I test it out tomorrow, but as of right now, it's fine. Outside of that, I haven't had the boat, but I think it's going on 6 months, 7 months, probably 7 months now, maybe longer than that. I've had it since July, so 6-7 months. And since then, I had already done one car clean. I had changed out the spark plugs, just your regular maintenance stuff. So that's why I was kind of iffy about it being something super, super serious. And it still could benefit from a carb cleaner. So I might still get at that and just see what, just to do it, because that wouldn't hurt it. Plus, tournament season is January, so tournament season coming up, so it would help to have everything running and running right. So other than that, it's not much to it. The only thing that I can say is to keep all of the stuff that you need in your boat. So, I just finished working on the spark plugs. I'm going to keep some of the old ones in the boat with me, just in case, you never know what happened on the water. So, keep some of the old ones in there. Yeah, I got these right here. In this box, I keep just, if anytime I work on something, whatever size wrench or, whatever, I keep it in here. In there right now. In this bag, I got mountain bolts for my jack plate. In case something goes wrong with that, I got mountain bolts for that. I got wire, all kinds of stuff in there, just some stuff that I want to use. Just in case something goes wrong, you want to make sure that you got it and put these somewhere else so that they don't rust.